Imagine writing, deploying, and running code not on a server controlled by Amazon or Google, but rather on an open, transparent platform controlled by the public. You could create code that isn't privately owned, but shared by the public. Code that acts as a true public good. Or imagine deploying code that is privately controlled, but publicly auditable. These open solutions exist today, powered by blockchains. Code deployed to a blockchain is called a smart contract and gives developers the ability to build powerful new applications. So with that, let's dive right in. In the 1990s, Nick Szabo, a distinguished computer scientist, coined the term smart contract to refer to a computer protocol that automatically and autonomously executed the terms of a contract. Nick went on to design a protocol named BitGold, which became an inspiration for the Bitcoin blockchain. However, it wasn't until 2013 that Nick's concept of smart contracts would return in the famous Ethereum white paper. Blockchains of the early 2010s, such as Bitcoin, were application specific. This meant that blockchains were created for a specific use case, such as the Bitcoin blockchain being made to transfer Bitcoin. Developers would have to design and bootstrap an entirely new blockchain just to create a new application. These application-specific blockchains can be considered a very basic form of smart contracts. For example, the Bitcoin blockchain automatically and autonomously executes code that transfers Bitcoin. In 2013, Bitcoin writer Vitalik Buterin was excited by the benefits of blockchain-based applications and recognize the inefficiency of bootstrapping a new blockchain for every application. To address this shortcoming, Vitalik released a white paper describing a blockchain where all the nodes run a virtual machine rather than just maintaining a ledger of transactions. You can find a link to the Ethereum white paper in the description below. He named the blockchain Ethereum and called the virtual machine the Ethereum Virtual Machine, or EVM. Vitalik referred to the code stored on Ethereum and run by the EVM as smart contracts. Today, the term smart contract is almost exclusively used to refer to code stored and run on blockchains. Ethereum launched in 2015 and is still the most adopted smart contract blockchain today. Smart contracts on Ethereum are primarily written in the programming language Solidity. Solidity is a high-level, statically typed, object-oriented programming language designed specifically for the needs of the EVM. Solidity compiles into bytecode, which the EVM can interpret. Today, several other blockchains, such as Polygon, Avalanche, and Arbitrum, support the EVM, and thus, smart contracts written in Solidity. However, newer blockchains, such as Solana and Terra, are beginning to run completely different virtual machines than the EVM. The VMs for both the Solana and Terra blockchain currently target the high-level language Rust. This industry is still extremely young and changing fast. Non-EVM blockchains are gaining popularity with developers, and it remains to be seen if any single blockchain or blockchain virtual machine will dominate the smart contract market. Because smart contracts inherit the powerful decentralized properties of blockchains, smart contract applications are more open, transparent, and egalitarian. Businesses can take advantage of smart contracts to offer more efficient and transparent services at lower prices. Conversely, smart contracts also come with trade-offs that introduce new consideration for developers, such as security concerns around transparent code, the immutability of deployed smart contracts, and lower throughput of transactions. These issues arise from the decentralized nature of blockchains, and solutions to mitigate each issue are still an active area of development. Throughout history, contracts have evolved from being written and stored on paper to being written and stored on computers as digital agreements. Most contracts today are digital agreements, and most applications are backed by digital agreements known as service level agreements, or SLAs. The enforcement of these SLAs is entirely controlled by the companies that create them. Furthermore, most applications today are run on one of just a few cloud services, such as AWS, Google Cloud, and Microsoft Azure. Blockchains offer a new type of application platform that developers can leverage, a platform that is controlled not by a single entity, but rather by the individuals running the nodes. Smart contracts, coupled with blockchains, offer an appealing alternative to the digital agreement-based applications available today. Smart contracts allow developers to write software that gives power back to the users by using cryptography and game theory to guarantee code will execute as written. Smart contracts are driving the next evolution of both agreements and the internet. And by first understanding blockchains, you will better understand how to build the next impactful smart contract. And with that, I'll hash you in the next block.